In this video, I'm going to show you how you can take a normal black and white logo and turn it into a neon sign inside After Effects. Let's dive in. So the first step that I'm going to do is create a new composition. I'm going to go up to Composition, New Composition. I'm just going to name this Neon Logo. And then from the preset, I'm just going to choose 1920 by 1080, set my frame rate to 29, and then my duration to 30, and then click OK. Then I'm going to import my logo and add it to my composition. I'm going to resize my logo, so I'm going to click S on my keyboard, or you can go up to the new properties panel and scale it down. I'm going to set my logo to 35. And then once you have it set, I'm going to toggle on the transparency grid. That way we can see through it. So next, click on the layer and right click on it. Then go to layer styles and then click on stroke. This will add a stroke to your logo. When you twirl down stroke, you have different options. We can change the color. So change the color to black. You can change the size of it. I'm going to change my size to 6. And then you have other options such as the position. I'm going to leave it on outside, but you also have the option to change to center or inside. So the next step is to duplicate the layer. So I'm going to click on it, go up to edit, duplicate. So next I'm going to change the track mat option for the bottom layer, select the other layer, then click it again to enable Luma Mat, and then click the invert switch next to that. Then you'll notice only the black stroke is visible. Now say if you have a black logo and you want to make it white to begin with, what you can do is search for the fill effect inside effects and presets, add it to your layer, and then change the color to white. But back to our composition here, what we're going to do is select these two layers and pre-compose it. So I'm going to right click and go to pre-compose, then I'm going to name it logo outline and click OK. Now what we're going to do is create the color effect. To do that, go up to layer, new solid. I'm going to name this color and then click OK. Just make sure that it's comp size and then click OK. Then I'm going to search for color gradient in my effects and presets. I'm going to drag and drop the 4 color gradient to my layer. Then I'm going to change the track mat of the solid to display the alpha channel into that logo outline layer. I'm going to enable the transparency grid. That way we can see our logo a little bit better. Now up in effects and presets, you have a few different options. You can change the color of these different 4 color points, and you also have the ability to change the location of these points as well. Now what I'm going to do here is enable the animation for the point. So I'm going to click on the stopwatches and then go out in my timeline a little bit to maybe 1 second, and then just move these points around to create a pretty cool different color shifting effect. And when we click U on our keyboard, you'll see all of our keyframes. What I'm going to do is option click on the stopwatch and then add an expression by going to the add button and then to properties and then to loop out. And then what we're going to do is change it from cycle to ping pong, and this will ping pong the animation. Next, what I'm going to do is copy and paste that expression to all the other points for this 4-way color effect. And then when we play it back, you'll notice that it ping pongs the color effect. So it plays through and then it reverses it. This is an easy way to time reverse or loop your animation inside After Effects. So next what I'm going to do is select these layers and pre-compose them one more time here. I'm going to name it colored logo and then click OK. Now we'll create the glow effect. So to do that, I'm going to duplicate it by hitting Command or Control D on my keyboard. I'm going to go to effects and presets and search for blur, and the blur we'll add is the Gaussian blur. I'm going to add that to my layer and change the blurriness to 100. Then I'm going to click on the layer and duplicate it again. And then for the second blurred logo, we can maybe add an expression, maybe a wiggle expression. So I'm going to option click and add wiggle, open parentheses 1, 100. And this seems to be a pretty decent wiggle animation that I've experimented with. You'll notice when we click play here, it kind of pulsates a little bit with the different glow in the background. One last thing we can do here is click on the top layer and add an inner glow. And this will kind of add that neon tube type of effect that you would see in a neon sign. So I'm going to change the color to white, and then I'm going to change the opacity to 100 and the blending mode to normal. And then if we scroll down, we're going to change the size to 10. And now you can see that if we zoom in here, you'll kind of see that white on the edges there, kind of giving a neon sign type of look. So this is the end result. And as you can see, we have a nice neon sign effect inside Adobe After Effects. Now, if you're working with text, there's another way that you can do it from scratch. If you want to see how to do that, I will link that video right up there. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.